Once there was a purpose, so I hear there was a God. It made it all less worthless, and it gave us the because we'd all been searching for. Unarguable truth. A reason to be kind and just. A reason for the noose that sent the sinner off to sinnerland and made us all feel better in the knowledge that the righteous would be right and just forever. Once there was religion and it ruled and we all had it bad. We fooled ourselves to sleep at night, said this was this and that was that. And if our morals ever shook, we looked no further than the book. But gradually we felt the pressure, it became the great oppressor. And without God, the wars seemed crueler, life seemed stranger, art seemed foolish, death seemed bleaker now than ever. What was mankind for? What terror flooded us to understand? There was no point, no grander plan. There was just living out each day. Work, eat, sleep, fuck, pass away. Now without the fear of retribution, we found guilt-free pleasure. But we lost the sense of union that had kept us all together, and we needed something new to fill the emptiness that grew. And what's better to believe in than all you can eat? Freedom. The dream of being who you are by virtue of the things you buy. The joy of getting rich enough to live outside the common life. And now there is no virtue that exists beyond our greed. Now there is the worship of experience and need, and we run around these circuits, pit our grace against our greed, and all we have is surplus to what's needed, and we feed our callous little urchins in the best ways that we can, and then we wonder how they've grown to only know what's in their hands. Because now we have the screen, and it rules, and our kids are perma-plugged into its promise, and they're admiring all its jewels, and our couples eat their dinner in the glimmer of its rays, and we stare until we've learned the world's ways. Preteens learn what heartthrobs are. Heartthrobs gorge on hot pork and watch sport. Morality showed for us to sneer and weep at. Here's our morality at last. See us caught in full colour, high definition. Look, a cripple on a blind date. Look, young people getting fucked in Magaluf. Look, the mother of a dead son weeping irate. Look, a celebrity eating shit and singing agadoo. They used to burn women who had epileptic fits. They would tie you to a stake and they'd proclaim you a witch. Now they'll put you on the screen if you've got nice tits, but you will be torn apart if you let yourself slip. And they'll draw red rings around your saggy bits, and they'll flick through the pictures while they eat bags of chips, because you can either be a beauty or a beast or a bitch. You can either be kooky or cool or kitsch. Look, before you were damned for the things that you did, or if you didn't live how the villagers lived, but now you're handed the mold and told fit into this. And maybe one day you could really be big. Behind the scenes footage of the famous last gig, the backstage close-up of the singer's last twitch before she pulls her gun out and she blows herself to bits. Yes, the world is your playground. Go and get your kicks. As long as you're not poor or ugly or sick, we never saw it coming, just like all the best tricks. Because yes, once we had the fear, but now we have the fix.